Let us see some of the consequences of propagation of electromagnetic waves in free space. Number one, transverse nature of electromagnetic waves. Now the four Maxwell's equations in terms of the operators ik and minus I omega can be written as k dot E equal to 0, k dot H equal to 0, minus k cross H equal to omega epsilon naught E, and k cross E equal to omega mu naught H. These are the four Maxwell's equations in terms of the operator ik and minus I omega. Now from equation A, that is k dot E equal to 0, we can say that vector E is perpendicular to the direction of propagation k. Also from equation B, that is k dot H equal to 0, we can say that vector H is perpendicular to the direction of propagation of the wave. So from both these equations we can say both E and H are perpendicular to the direction of propagation of the electromagnetic wave, or we can say that electromagnetic waves are transverse in nature. Now again from equation D, we have k cross E is equal to omega mu naught H. This means that vector H is perpendicular to both k and E. So from here we can conclude E, H and k are orthogonal. So we can show the direction of propagation of an electromagnetic waves like this. Suppose this is the x-axis, this is the y-axis and this is the z-axis. So we can show it like this. So let this be the direction of E, vector E, this be H, then this is the direction of the propagation of the electromagnetic wave, that is along the Z direction. Now let us see the characteristic impedance of free space. Now from the equation K cross E equal to omega mu naught H, we have H equal to 1 by omega mu naught into k cross E. Also k is equal to magnitude of k and the product of the unit vector along the propagation of the wave, that is k into the unit vector n. Also, we have k equal to omega by c. Putting these values in the above equation, we have k cross e equal to omega mu naught h, and h since is equal to 1 by omega mu naught k cross e, we have h equal to 1 by omega mu naught omega by c n cross e. So we get h equal to 1 by mu naught c n cross e. Also, we know that vector b equal to mu naught h, and from above, mu naught h is equal to 1 by c n cross e, or we can write b equal to 1 by c n cross e. So this is the relation between the vector b and e. Now h equal to 1 by mu naught c n cross e, or taking the moduli e and h, e by h in terms of the moduli, we have mu naught c. This is equal to mu naught c, and this can be written as mu naught into 1 by under root epsilon naught mu naught. Since c is equal to under root 1 by epsilon naught mu naught, using this we get the moduli, the ratio of the moduli e by h as equal to under root mu naught square by epsilon naught mu naught, and this is equal to under root mu naught by epsilon naught, and we can call it as a value z naught. As the ratio e by h is real in terms of the moduli and is positive, the vectors e and h are in phase, that is when e has the maximum value, h has also its maximum value. Also, from the above, it is clear that in an electromagnetic wave, the amplitude of the electric vector E is z naught times that of the magnetic vector H. Now let us find the value of z naught and see its unit. Now z naught is equal to under root mu naught by epsilon naught, and we know that mu naught by 4 pi is equal to 10 to the power minus 7 Tesla meter coulomb minus 1, and 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught is equal to 9 into 10 to the power 9 Newton meter square coulomb minus 2. Putting this value in the above equation, that is z naught equal to under root mu naught by epsilon naught is equal to 120 pi, and in terms of units this becomes equal to 377 ohm. That is, the unit comes out to be in terms of the impedance. This can be easily verified by seeing the units of E in terms of volt per meter and of H in terms of ampere turn per meter. So using these two, the value of Z naught equal to mu naught by epsilon naught comes out to be 377 ohm, which means that the quantity Z naught is some form of impedance, as its unit is ohms, and it is called the intrinsic or the characteristic impedance of the free space, and this is a constant having value 377 ohm. Now the third consequence is that the flow of energy in a plane wave in free space is in the direction of the wave propagation. This can be easily seen by the following. Now the pointing vector S is equal to E cross H. This is equal to E cross N cross E by C mu naught. Now S is equal to, by using vector quantity, E cross N cross E by C mu naught is equal to E dot E N vector minus E dot N E into 1 by C mu naught, as E dot N is equal to 0. So the above becomes S equal to E square N by C mu naught. As C mu naught is equal to Z naught, we can write S equal to 1 by Z naught E square N vector. Also, 1 by C mu naught equal to C epsilon naught. Therefore, S can be written as epsilon naught C epsilon naught E square N. Now, the average value of S can be written as S equal to 1 by or C epsilon naught average value of E square N. Now, what is the average value of E square? E square, the average value can be written as E naught e to the power minus I omega t minus k dot r, and its square, the average value, and this is equal to epsilon naught square cos square omega t minus k dot r. And we know that the average value of cos square theta is half, that is cos square theta, the average value is half. Therefore, cos square omega t minus k dot r is equal to half. Therefore, the average value of E square is equal to E naught square by 2, and this can be written as E naught by root 2 into E naught by root 2, and this is equal to E RMS square. Therefore, we have S equal to C epsilon naught E RMS square N, or this can be equal to 1 by Z naught E RMS square N. So we find that the propagation of energy takes place in the direction of the wave propagation. This is shown by this vector N. This is the vector along the direction of the propagation of wave. So S is along the direction of propagation of wave, that is the flow of energy is along the direction of the propagation of wave. Now the fourth consequence is that the electromagnetic energy in free space is transmitted with the speed of light. This can be shown like this. Now the electrostatic energy density UE is equal to half epsilon naught E square, and magnetostatic energy density UM is equal to half mu naught H square. Therefore UE by UM is equal to half epsilon naught E square by half mu naught H square. This is equal to epsilon naught by mu naught E square by H square, and this is equal to 1 as E by H is equal to under root mu naught by epsilon naught. Therefore UE is equal to UM. Now the total energy density U is equal to UE plus UM, and this is equal to 2 UE, and this is equal to 2 into half epsilon naught E square, and this is equal to epsilon naught E square. Now the average total energy density U is equal to epsilon naught E square, the average value of the E square, and this is equal to epsilon naught E naught e to the power minus I omega t minus k dot r whole square, like this. And this is equal to epsilon naught cos square omega t minus k dot r. And we know that the average value of cos square theta is half. So we have, this is equal to epsilon naught E naught square and half. And this can be written as epsilon naught E naught by root 2 into E naught by root 2. And this is equal to E naught E R M S square. So we get the average value of U equal to epsilon naught E R M S square. We have already found out the average value of the pointing vector S, and this is equal to epsilon naught C E R M S square to vector N. Therefore the value of average value of S by average value of U, this is equal to epsilon naught C E R M S square vector N by epsilon naught E R M S square, and this is equal to epsilon naught E, this is equal to epsilon naught C E R M S square N by epsilon naught E R M S square, and E R M S square by E R M S square, they get cancelled out. Epsilon naught is also cancelled out. So we are left with C into vector N. So that is, we have S equal to C U and vector N. This implies that the electromagnetic energy in free space is transmitted with the speed of light C. So we see that in case of propagation of electromagnetic wave in free space, The wave propagates with a speed equal to that of light in free space. Number 2, the electromagnetic waves are transverse in nature. Number 3, the wave vectors E and H are mutually perpendicular. Number 4, the vectors E and H are in phase. Number 5, the electrostatic energy density is equal to the magnetostatic energy density. And number 6, the electromagnetic energy is transmitted in the direction of wave propagation at speed C. So this is all about the propagation of electromagnetic waves in free space.